So you went to see Adele in England, correct?
Yeah, this was I had a big summer. I scored tickets to Adele's final show. Her final show, because you know she's like, Adele's never gonna tour again and all this stuff. So I managed to get tickets, really good tickets, to Adele's final show in London. My boss gives me special time off in July because July is a ratings period in news, so we're not allowed to take time off typically during that month. So I was like, look, I got these tickets, can I please? She was like, you can have 3 days, you can go. And I was like, okay, so I'm going. Took my mom, my friend went with her mom. It was this wonderful trip. And we're there, the show is on Sunday, and Saturday morning we wake up, and I had a text from my friend who was staying in a room down the hall, and she's like, don't freak out. Adele canceled the show.
Oh no!
She lost her voice. She had four shows for this final stretch in London at Wembley Stadium, and she did the Wednesday night show, the Thursday night show, Friday comes along. She goes to the doctor because she's lost her voice, and the doctor says, if you sing, you could hurt yourself so badly that you'll never sing again.
So?
So she canceled the final two shows.
Now, you know.
So I went all the way to London to not see Adele.
Not seeing Adele. If I remember right, Ashley Simpson lost her voice just before doing Saturday Night Live, and she figured out a fix.
She figured it out.
She figured it out.
I would have been happy to go to that stadium and sit and just stare at a silent Adele for 2 hours.
She could like tell jokes
just or tell
something.
Just tell some jokes.
Tell some stories.
Like sip some tea and tell some
why
jokes.
Why didn't she do that?
Yeah.
She didn't do it, she had
because,
a
you know why? Because Adele hates people.
No,
that's
I'm
why.
Sure.
That's exactly why.
Yeah, I think that's the takeaway
from the story. She's wonderful. She's a wonderfully talented person. But,